The RESDP aims to harness renewable energy resources and is scheduled to begin by the end of the year, with drilling rigs set to be placed at selected sites. Extensive consultations have been held with stakeholders, and ongoing discussions with local residents near the proposed sites have been prioritized to address concerns and provide clarity.
Right now, we're trying to complete the ESIA process, that's the Environmental and Social Impact Assessment. That process looks at how the project will impact the environment around the project sites and also how it will affect people who live around the project sites. Right now, we're doing the public disclosure of the ESIA and the associated environmental and social management plan. The purpose of the public disclosure is to give the public an opportunity to review the documents, review the plan to mitigate any negative impacts on the environment and people.
Dr. Ken Aldonza, project manager for RESDP, emphasized the importance of the initiative, highlighting other support measures for those potentially affected by the drilling activities. He expressed gratitude for the participation of residents in surveys, as their input enables the committee to make more informed decisions. Once these updates are finalized, the contractors will move forward with drilling operations.
We are also preparing a resettlement action plan, which deals with how we compensate people who are directly impacted by the project. So some people would lose some of the land, some people would have to be relocated. When it is approved by the World Bank and the DCA, we will be able to sign the contract to begin the civil works at the site. Another requirement to sign the civil works contract is for us to acquire the lands needed.
Susan Heim from Panorama Environmental Inc. provided insights into the potential sites for the geothermal project, outlining the criteria used for selecting locations in the southern part of the island.
We went to those three sites and we conducted biological resource, cultural resource, air quality, noise, and water quality sampling and testing to evaluate what is on the ground at the site, what are the actual conditions that are there. And then we looked at the physical footprint of where the drilling would occur and where the access roads would be located, and we assessed what are the impacts of the project on the environment that is there today.
The project manager also discussed the long-term benefits to the local population once the geothermal sites become operational, emphasizing the positive impact on the community and the environment.
This is a test project, so this is a way of evaluating, is there a geothermal resource that can be commercially viable? If there is a commercially viable resource, then there will be development as a future phase that is separate from the current test phase. And in the future, then the whole country of St. Lucia would benefit if there is a geothermal resource that could be exploited and developed, because then that would be power for everyone.
The geothermal drilling project is slated to begin by December of 2025, once all necessary regulations are met and contractors are selected. With an estimated cost of approximately $30 million, the project's goal is to leverage the country's natural geothermal resources to generate renewable electricity and contribute to the local economy. The three proposed drilling sites are located in Saltibus, Belvidere Fontaine-Jacques, and Belle Plaine-Soufrière. For the DBS News World, Manasseh Stanislas reporting.